All right, so I'm here by the castle in Oslo. So we're hanging out in the backyard of the king and the queen and all those suckers. I bet they're not even high carb raw vegan. So, I mean, they're losing out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can confirm that.
Yeah. Anyways, so I'm here with Maria. Maybe you want to introduce yourself.
Yes. So I'm Maria, I'm 17, and I've been on the raw food high carb diet since summer, since July.
Yeah, that's
and
cool.
And I feel great.
Yeah, that's cool. We all want to feel great. Yeah, I feel great too. So, Maria, what made you end up with a low-fat, high-carb, raw vegan diet, and where were you before, and what other things have you tried, and why have you tried them?
Yes, so last year I was really sick. I was hospitalized for a week because of the fact that my weight started dropping so low. I went from 60 kilo to 47.
Whoa.
And then to 39 when I was hospitalized.
39 kilos?
Yeah, 39. And that was the beginning of last year.
Yeah.
So, and we didn't actually, well, I started to eat less and less food because I felt really tired and I felt really ill. I had stomach aches, headaches almost every single day. So I noticed that when I was eating less food, I started to feel a little bit better, or I didn't have the stomach aches.
Oh, yeah.
But I didn't know what was the cause. And everybody thought, beside my parents, well, in the hospital, they all thought I was anorexic and I started eating less food because I wanted to drop weight. And
Yeah, but you actually ate less because you didn't feel as bad as when you did eat more food. Okay, so they thought you were anorexic. But what kind of food did you eat? Was it like the standard Norwegian diet?
It was. Like lots of milk, meat, fish, of course fish in Norway.
Yeah, and bread, I guess.
Yeah.
Lots of bread.
Yeah. Bread for almost every single meal.
Yeah.
Along with milk.
Yeah.
And yeah, so a lot of dairy and meat and bread. And then, well, I didn't feel any better. I gained maybe a few kilos of being in the hospital, but then suddenly my weight started dropping again.
Oh yeah.
And I had to eat, like, the doctors told me to eat more and more of gluten, like bread and cereals and all that kind of stuff, and dairy, of course.
Yeah.
And she added like extra yogurts for me to eat every single day.
Yeah. So in the hospital they gave you more grains and more dairy.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's Norwegian food, all right. Mm-hmm. Crazy stuff.
And well, in March, me and my mom, we went to see a private doctor who's actually a functional doctor. I don't know if that's it.
Yeah, I don't know either. Yeah, we'll just look it up and you know, paste some text in the video.
And the first time he saw me, he told me, "You're not anorexic. And you should know that you shouldn't be eating gluten or dairy." He didn't took any tests yet, But he was so sure of it. He was pretty much, that was like obvious for him when he first saw me and talked to me.
Yeah.
That he told me to stop them, to stop dairy and gluten, so bread and.
Yeah. So that grains. Basically removes half the diet for all Norwegians.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Half the diet for all Norwegians. That's right.
Yeah.
And well, in March I also went vegan because of, well, one was because of health reasons. That was one thing, but it was also kind of ethical, because I've always wanted to become vegan and vegetarian. I've never liked meat as a child.
Yeah, yeah.
But since my parents always ate meat and my whole family told me that meat was actually is very healthy for you.
Yeah, yeah.
Everyone around me told me the same. So I kind of forced myself to eat meat, even though I remember that dinner was the last, like, the least favorite meal of the day, at least.
Yeah, yeah. But then also, because you don't want to eat the normal diet, I guess people also tend to think that you have some kind of eating disorder. Because you want to say no,
that's
to
right.
Some stuff that they think is very, very normal, and that's just wrong in their mind. So
exactly, they say that. Well,
yeah. So they basically think you're a weirdo.
Yeah.
For,
they
you
think
know,
I'm
like,
a weirdo.
Yeah, yeah.
If I don't eat meat or dairy or anything like that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So that was in March, and in April, then I was vegan, completely vegan.
Yeah, that's cool.
But the doctor took some tests on me, and I was diagnosed with Candida and the leaky gut syndrome.
Oh yeah, Candida and leaky gut syndrome.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
And also I had too much copper and zinc.
Oh, yeah.
So
that's kind of strange though, having too much zinc, because that's not very common. I guess copper is easier to get more of, but zinc is the kind of thing that, like,
I don't know, I think it's weird because I don't know how that's even possible, but
yeah.
I was diagnosed with that in April. So what the doctor told me was to eat a very low carb diet. So I basically had to lower, like, eat no fruits at all because of Candida. So
oh my. Yeah. Yeah.
And eat a lots and lots of fats and protein, since I didn't eat meat or fish because I obviously told him I was vegan.
Yeah. So the doctor told you to drop all carbs basically and eat lots of what?
Lots of fat and protein.
Fat and protein.
Because I didn't eat any fish, because I obviously told him I went vegan. He asked me to find other things that could replace the protein. So I looked up online, and of course I saw that tempeh and tofu.
So beans, lentil. No, but they have
also
have carbs.
Also, but
so
carbs,
yeah.
Problem.
But nuts and seeds then maybe.
Nuts and seeds and nut butters and all that. So my whole diet actually revolved in nuts and seeds.
Oh yeah.
To be honest, I barely even ate vegetables. Fruits was a no-no, except for berries. So was happy that I was allowed to eat berries.
Yeah.
But so, well, that ended up really bad for me.
Oops.
In 1 week, a whole week, I had stomach aches, and it couldn't stop in 1 week.
Yeah.
And
this was after how long on the fat and protein diet?
I think it was like after 2 weeks or
okay.
something. Well, I did start to feel less energetic and just I didn't feel good.
Yeah.
Even if on the first weeks, but like the low part, like when I felt the worst was after those 2-3 weeks.
Yeah. So, but did your weight go up anything then?
Well, my weight did get up a little bit, but I mean, not really, because it was like a period when I ate so much fat and nuts, I had like stomach aches and all that because I couldn't go to the toilet, so.
Oh yeah, so you got like constipated and stuff?
I did, really bad.
Oh, that's horrible.
And then, well, the doctor told me to stop eating those fats and eat more protein instead.
Okay.
And if I can, I...
So we have ruled out the carbs because you have candida, and carbs like sugar and fruit are like the killer, you know, when you got candida. And so you got like fats and protein, but then the fats were too hard to digest for your sensitive system. So that leaves protein, eat protein.
Yeah, eat protein and be healthy, right?
Oh, yeah.
So we bought protein powder, vegan protein powder.
Yeah, like rice protein or pea protein or something
Pea and rice, exactly.
Yeah.
And I had flavors, chocolate and vanilla, so I was kind of happy to have sugary flavors. Anyways, I ate the protein powders for every single meal, actually.
Whoa.
With
but what did you do about, like, you eat some multivitamins or stuff?
Yeah.
Something like that too, like.
I had to.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Even when I ate only fat, I had like tons of vitamins to take every single day. And I mean tons.
Yeah, and I guess those probably didn't make it easier for you to digest your food either, because they don't really work like a fruit or a berry or something like that.
I didn't feel any better after eating. You're supposed to feel good after having vitamins, and everybody says that you need those vitamins to feel good and to be healthy, obviously.
Yeah, yeah.
To be honest, I didn't feel any better only by eating vitamins, supplements.
Yeah.
So, eating protein powder with soy milk and soy yogurt.
But then also, I mean, soy, I mean, it's a good protein, like complete protein, but if you're already like really sensitive in your digestive system, then soy protein can be kind of harsh also.
Well, I think it was really harsh on me.
Yeah.
Because I got reflux.
Yeah, like it came back up.
Yeah,
basically.
It came back up with blood.
Blood. So you were like coughing blood and getting like stomach acids and food and blood coming up again. Because you were eating so healthy.
That was really funny. It wasn't fun at
all. Oh man, no.
Not fun.
No, that's crazy. That's crazy. I mean,
it was.
Yeah, I'm glad you're here with us now. And
yeah.
Looking healthy and good, and yeah, that's awesome.
And my weight started dropping.
Your
big
weight
surprise.
Dropped even more.
Yeah.
Oh.
My lowest weight was 35 kilos, folks.
35 kilos?
35.
And you're how tall? You're almost my height.
I'm like, 165.
Yeah, 165, that's my height. Yeah.
Yeah.
35 kilos. That's just insane.
That's incredible. And well, I didn't have energy at all. I barely even could walk.
Yeah, yeah.
And going to school was a disaster for me. I couldn't concentrate. I was so ill.
Yeah.
It was terrible. And during summer, I went to the States with my mom, and actually I know a girl, I knew her from Instagram, and she told me about the 80-10-10. So when I was in the States, I went to the library and the bookstore, well, and I bought the book. Then right after reading the book, actually, we went to Whole Foods, I remember that, and for lunch I had 15 peaches.
Nice.
That was amazing.
Yeah, I guess you were in heaven then.
Like, I was, because I was well, my doctor didn't know about that, so hush.
Yeah.
No, but
so you got the 80-10-10 diet book of Dr. Doug Graham.
Yes.
And then you read it, and then you went to Whole Foods, and you went crazy on the peaches. Yeah, that's awesome.
Because I wasn't allowed to eat fruit, so when I decided I was allowed to, because I kind of took my health in my own hands.
I don't know. Good for you. Yeah, I'm glad you did.
Yeah. And
you hear that? You take responsibility for your own health.
That's right.
Yeah, that's the stuff.
And I also started watching some 80-10-10. People on YouTube. So,
yeah.
All the raw high carb community, like Rahul, Christina, and Freely, and Durander, and so on.
Yeah.
And Rob here.
Well, yeah. I wasn't on YouTube then.
Recently.
Yeah, yeah. I guess I showed up in quite a few clips here and there, but yeah.
And well, after eating 15 peaches for lunch, I had more fruit after, well, for dinner and then supper.
Yeah, so what did you have for dinner then?
I can't quite remember now. I only remember the peaches, because that was the first fruit.
Yeah.
And that was actually like I will always remember the face my mom did when I had all those peaches on the table and was ready to eat them. My mom just made the funniest face, and she told me, "You're never gonna be able to finish those peaches."
Yeah, right.
Well,
she
I
didn't
showed
know
her
what she was talking about. Yeah,
no.
Got a fruit monster here.
I love fruits. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
but what happened? I mean, your blood sugar should have gone way up through the roof, and you should have crashed and burned, and you should have like had stomach aches and from all the carbs
and
the candida
should
have just been
destroyed me.
Yeah, but what happened?
I don't know. My weight. Well, I gained some weight.
Oh yeah, so you started gaining weight then. That means that you were actually able to absorb the nutrients and.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah.
And actually, I also stopped taking my vitamins, because I already did it, and then you don't need supplements. And that's right, you don't need them. You don't need them if you eat your fruits, folks.
Yeah, that's good advice. Good advice right there. Yeah.
So that was what I did, and when I came back, the doctor was shocked. He was just shocked about how I looked, how good I looked, and
he was like, "Wow, that's my protein stuff doing its work."
Yeah, no, I told him, "Know what? I stopped taking those supplements. I stopped eating like you told me to, and I started eating 80-10-10. So I started only eating fruits, lots of fruits and some vegetables."
Yeah.
And
what did he say? Did he like beat you up or something?
No, he was actually very open to it. He's very nice. So, and he actually bought the book.
He bought the book. Yeah, that's cool. That's a cool doctor, actually.
It is.
Instead of just spewing his dogma and telling people what to do, actually observing what happens, you know, when people do something and like taking it in and learning something new from a patient that's like 17 years old, like third or of his age or something, you know. I think that's cool. That's a cool doctor.
And he also bought the China study.
Ah, yeah, yeah.
I told him about the China study and
yeah.
I showed him the books on Amazon.
Yeah, yeah, that's cool. That's cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
Very happy.
So you started gaining weight, and that was this summer?
This summer and over the past few months. And
yeah.
I guess I'm still gaining.
Yeah.
I don't actually know. I don't weigh myself, so no, I have no idea, but I feel great.
Yeah, you look perfectly healthy now. And
thank you.
Do you have the energy to like start working out a little bit?
Oh, yeah. I've been working out at least once a week.
Yeah.
And I feel like it is weird to explain it, but when I have so much fruits and I feel so much. Feel so energetic and that I am full of energy, and I just want to work out. I want to go out. I want to run. I want. It is crazy, and I hate running. Before I remember I absolutely hated running, and I couldn't stand it. And now I'm just like, I want to run. Let's run. So.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, I've been running around my neighborhood, and I feel great.
Yeah. Do you lift weights? Do you work your strength?
I do.
Yeah. Are you having some progress?
I'm starting to. I'm starting to see progress, so I'm very happy, and we'll see how that will take me.
Yeah, yeah. So are you feeling stronger? And I mean, like, are you increasing the weights and stuff?
Yes. And the first funny weight at first was during summer, actually, when I went back from. The States, we bought watermelons, and I did squats with watermelon.
Oh yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
Watermelon squats. Yeah.
That was like the first kind of weight training ish I had.
Yeah.
And
yeah, that's a good exercise though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is, and it is for free. You can do it for free. Well, you only buy the watermelon, of course.
Yeah.
But,
and when you get stronger and you don't have any melons, you can just, you know, pick up a friend, put them on their shoulders and do your squats or whatever, you know.
Sure, be as creative as you want.
Yeah.
But now I go to the gym. I have a gym membership, and I go there at least once a week if I And sometimes I try to go more, but it is kind of difficult with school right now.
Yeah,
I
understand.
Have lots of studying.
Yeah.
But I mean, there's always time for everything. There's always time for workout. So.
Yeah.
Even though I don't go to the gym every single day but I work out at home because it's not that I have to, it's just I want to. And
I mean, taking a 10-minute break from the schoolwork, just, you know, doing some simple exercise with some dumbbells or whatever, you know, like work out in your kitchen.
I mean, with your fruits, like work out and then you eat your fruit.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Like do your squats with your watermelon, then just have it for breakfast afterwards.
That's
fine.
yeah.
That's what I did.
All right. So you had like candida, leaky gut. What else are there? Did you mention some? You got some problems also from like heavy metals and stuff like that?
Yeah.
So that was from eating all the fish and stuff that we eat here in Norway. Yeah. So do you think that is something that was that came to be because you were unable to like get those stuff get those metals out of your body? Or I mean, All people eat fish, but not everybody has a problem with like mercury and stuff.
I think I have a really sensitive digestion and I mean, I've always had problems since I was a little girl, but no one really took it seriously. Everyone thought that it was all normal, just every kid, you know, Almost everyone has those kind of problems, but then those problems became
severe.
Yeah.
Yeah. But so now you've been eating fruit for like half a year almost, and your digestion is working all right. You mentioned you had lots of constipation and stuff before.
I had, yeah.
And now?
Now, well, it is perfect. I can tell you, I've never had this kind of digestion ever, ever in my life.
That's awesome. And once again, we hear fruitarians talk about their poo. You know, all the fruitarians do, because it becomes so natural, and it's not a taboo anymore, because it just works so well, and everybody's happy with how their digestion is working. And you never ever bring anything to read or whatever to the bathroom, because you won't even have time to open a newspaper or whatever you bring there. You don't have time to open a book because you're done. I mean, when you sit down, you're done, and it's just awesome.
Feel great.
yeah.
You feel awesome. And
yeah, that's cool. All right, Maria, thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, and you have, you're on Twitter and stuff like that?
Instagram account.
Instagram. Yeah, that's cool.
I have an Instagram. The Healthy New Life. So
okay,
I
the
think
healthy
we'll
new
insert
life.
A link or something.
Yeah, I'll insert a link, you know, some stuff there. Yeah.
Yeah,
so subscribe to her on Instagram or however it works. I'm actually not on Instagram. Maybe I should be. I don't know. I don't know if I have the time to do that.
Thumbs up if you think Rob should have an Instagram.
Okay, if I get 100 thumbs up for this video, I'll do Instagram. I promise. You know, and now I have it on video, and I can't get away from that. No excuses. Just gotta do it.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you so much.
It was so
nice talking to you, and thank you for sharing your story with the viewers. And it's been awesome. All right. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thumbs up, you post your comments and questions down below, maybe suggestions for future videos, you know, any questions you might have, and you subscribe to my channel, and you go raw, and you just keep at it and keep on keeping on.
Go subscribe, guys.
Yeah.